Level.
Third of the quarterfinals in the day session then here. The world champion Wang Manyu meeting Mimarito for the second straight week. And won last time around at the Star Contender. Can it be a case of history repeating or a different outcome here?
Nice adjustment from Mimarito here. Ball comes in off the top of the net and she's able to hold back, slow down the racket for a moment just to spin it down the line. And as you mentioned, Guy, I mean, it came down to the wire last time. It was a five-gamer full distance, so the crowd's in for a treat here.
Yeah, an early pointer there in terms of it's not the case so much this event because all the matches being played here on the Infinity Arena, but in terms of the way World Table Tennis is taking things forward, they actually played out on Table 2 on our YouTube streaming coverage at the Star Contender, giving you all those options. And of course, this week there is the WTT feeder event, some really, really quality action going on there. You can keep across all of that through the app, WTT app. Through our YouTube streaming as well. No need for any of that here because we've just got these top players here on this main table, the Infinity Arena. No need to look anywhere else.
Yeah, it's nice to know you're in the place to be. It does make it easy. I mean, this has been the vision for table tennis for a long time. You know, you don't have professional boxing matches side by side where you're like, oh, what? I missed the knockout punch? You are watching the best action in the world right now, and it's tied up.
Two, three.
Now, we haven't gone into this yet, but if you're just joining us, Mimarito has a very unusual style and a fairly unusual setup. On her backhand, the red side of the racket has short pips. That means she puts less rotation on the ball when she spins, and she loves to flat hit. Or with the backhand, as we call it, Mima Punch.
Yeah, and it's the Mima Punch that the Chinese national team, get your thoughts on this through the first towel breaking out, and then that they really looked at, because she was beating from, of course, extremely young, beating members of the Chinese national team, and they were really, I've spoken to you about this before, really studied how to solve the Mima problem, which is what they've done in recent times.
We don't talk about the Mima problem. That was the attitude for a while.
Three, four.
Effortless from Wang Manyu. And there's just that look from Mima like, right, okay.
It's a very special Japanese sound. It's not made anywhere else in the world, really.
It's those flat attacks, though, as you said, through the pips on the backhand side that troubled them for a while. But we've seen in the meetings that she's had with members, the top members of the Chinese national team in recent times, a different story. They do seem to have firmly got to grips with that.
Yeah, they've adapted quite well, as they tend to. I mean, when you've got the best resources, the hardest workers, the deepest thinkers in the game on your side, there's no shortage of resources to adapt. And if it takes focus, it takes focus. You know, there was a press conference I showed up at, and people were being shy and polite, and I just raised my hand and asked the Chinese team, so what are you going to do about Mimarito? And they were like, well, she's just like another player. And I'm like, no, not really. She's beaten all your best players. So if you really believe that, I don't believe you. And they answered it a little bit more seriously, but they clearly put in the work. I mean, behind closed doors, she's the only face on the wall for the women to be concerned about, and they've done an outstanding job of sort of silencing the threat. In recent years, I mean, you saw Shasha at the Olympic Games.
Oh, yeah. I was about to say, Adam, we were both out there, obviously, on that event. And there's that punch.
Six.
Now, this is a smart combination of play here. The serve shorter to the forehand side. Watch this. Very short. Brings in Wang Manyu for that backhand receive where she knows she can get a little bit more rotation, but it exposes her on the deep backhand corner and that one-inch Bruce Lee-esque Mima punch for the win.
Five, seven.
It's funny, the service game, I remember back, I want to say 2019, but Mimarito had two tournaments, Swedish Open, and one other, I'm going to say Japan, where she just steamrolled through everybody. Zhu Yuling, I think, was world number one right around that time. And 4-0, Mima Ito beat her, holding her to an average of less than 5 points a game. I mean, that's scarring.
Six.
The intent was clear, the execution not so that time from Ito. Yeah, no, it was how it was all built up, really. And it's funny how life turns, doesn't it? You know, you going forward to the home Olympics as well at that time, those matches you talk about, because that was the narrative at that time. You know, Mima Ito can win Olympic singles gold. That was clearly the case. Of course, that's before the coronavirus pandemic hit everything else. She did win a gold medal, of course, Ito, that memorable mixed final alongside Mizutani.
Was actually having this conversation with some Chinese fans in the lobby last night. That's the standard of China, that four gold medals and one silver is a failure in the eyes of the Chinese Table Tennis Association.
Seven, eight.
You know, we haven't talked about too much the difference in physicality. We talked about it in the last match, but here it's even more pronounced. By height, I mean, You're talking half a foot between these two. They look like completely different age groups, which means different skill sets and different styles of play for each player.
Well, I mean, back on your earlier point, I mean, it's a lot of how they constructed the Mima Ito game is about that, Adam, isn't it? I mean, you talk about the pips on the backhand side, where she occupies the table, the punches, everything else, the variety off the service. It's to do with what she's got, what you're given.
Right. I mean, it's a stoic approach, and it's just a logical approach, really. If you can't control it, don't worry about it. So work with what you're given, be happy with what you've got, and do the best with what you have here. 5 points in a row. Wang Manyu was down 5-7 at the towel break.
3 game points now, though, for the Chinese. And only needs the one.
11-7.
So misses the receive there, trying to come round and punch. It's Wang Manyu here with the first punch in this quarterfinal, delivered expertly. 11-7. We talked about it actually across the commentary team, haven't we, the past couple of weeks. I mean, where do you stand on that? Best serves in the women's game?
Mima Ito.
Yeah.
I mean, is there a conversation there? Who?
No, I was just posing it to you.
No, it's a good question. It sounded like there was some conversation. It sounds like a short conversation to me.
I can understand why you want to make it a short conversation. I mean, just see it there. And it's all, isn't it? You talk about that being the shot that's in your control as well. And, you know, that embodies the mentality, isn't it? It's the shot. It's the one shot. It starts the rally. And it's that variety, isn't it? The variation that she's got.
Yeah. When have you seen Mima Ito chop? She tried chopping from behind the table. She's capable of anything. Here's one. Next, second chop. I mean, there are choppers that have short pips on their backhand. She's like, well, tried it. It's funny, you said make this a short conversation. For me, I just think it is a short conversation. I'm just observing. Yeah, I'm sure there are other opinions, but that's how it looks to me.
Cool.
Another thing about the whole tricks, trying to be creative and be a step ahead, she's constantly reinventing herself. Mm. Her serves have evolved in many ways. It's sort of a game of catch me if you can. You figured out my old serves? That's the burner cell phone. She's burning the old serves and she's bringing out new ones, so she has no one on her trail. Or at least that's the plan. But for the last few years, since 2019, it feels like the footprints haven't been covered up well enough.
Let 3-2. Oh. 2.
Come around, a look of disgust there from Wang Manyu. Seeing the backhand flick receive. Ito wanting the table to be wiped down here, having opened up this lead of a couple of points at the first towel break. Where she's so good, I mean, so talking about the current world champion here, and we're both out in Houston as well. Where Wang Manyu is so good is she's such a smart player, isn't she? We talk about Ito's, just on this, Ito's various strengths and what she's doing. Wang Manyu very, very good as a problem solver at getting it out. In this case, as you just out of the sweet spot of Ito on the punch, for example.
Yeah, I think you have to be. You can't be a world-class player and not be smart, but she's next level, as you mentioned. A world champion. And also, this is an open book test, to some extent. You have your coach in the corner, and not just any coach, but a Grand Slam champion, Zhang Jike's personal coach, Xiao Jian, who's, I mean, world-class as they come as a coach.
5-4.
Tomahawk serve here, under and side spin. Net recovered, Mima Ito. To flap up both wings there for a minute just to change the timing and stay on top of the bounce after the net break.
Let 5-4.
Ooh.
Oh, no.
5-0.
It's funny, just before this, I was actually thinking, maybe I was thinking too hard about it, but when Lily Zhang's serve touched her face against Du Hoi Kim in a timeout here, and then right after that, she corrected the umpire. She said, no, not let.
Yeah, that was great to see, actually. I remember that was earlier on in the event. Wang here resuming, rather, with the service. There we go.
5-6.
Receive of high quality on the resumption. Points taken and a confidence struck from Ito. Going to the second towel break. Run of points on receive continues here since the timeout. Server has not won a point yet since then. Interesting. We talked earlier, obviously, about when Ito beat the top Chinese players, how they studied her game. Obviously, on the other side of things, the Japanese national team are not exactly shy of doing that sort of work. They're very meticulous as well in terms of their setup. You know that, Adam, as well. They would have been looking at this. Okay, you're 2-10. You've lost last week. Okay, what can we do differently this time?
I wonder. I wonder how much of that is a national association decision and how much of it is just Team Mima, like the Mima Ito camp, personally. It feels a little bit more individualistic in that way.
8, 9.
And obviously they have an incredibly strong national team.
Timeout
now on Wang Manyu's side.
Both timeouts utilized in this second game. Nod there from Wang Manyu after the timeout from Xiao Jian.
Perfect read of the topspin coming in. Lina Ito doing a kick serve. Side and topspin from the shovel position. But a good read on the receive to set up those two game points.
Oh, well done.
A lot of pressure right on the middle, and Wang Manyu is a taller player, has that crossover. It looked like the banana split, meaning the Chiquita receive with underspin. If nothing else, straight side, but there appeared to be no top on that flick. That's a Mima Ito specialty. Still one game point to go for Wang Manyu. Long push, well done, fast and dead to the deep backhand. Take another look. Empty floating shot to the very baseline of the table. So, crucial points here, alternating serves, as you would say.
Yep, definitely, and that 2-point clear winning margin needed to take the game. Rips that one low through the backhand side, Wang Manyu.
This is tough for Mima Chan. This isn't where she wants to be. I mean, there's a longer conversation about what changed after Mima dominated the Chinese opponents several times in a row taking a title, and her loss to Duhui Kim just a week later in Austria. Third game point for Wang Manyu.
Oh, fantastic rally to close the second game that goes the way of the world champion. Wang Manyu here right on top of this quarterfinal on Mimarito now after toughing out the second, 12-10.
Third game, one to serve, level.
One more game required then for the world champion to book her spot in the semi-finals of this inaugural WTT Champions event.
One, zero.
I feel like Mimarito's been in this so far. Not much to show for it, where it really counts on the scoreboard. Lost the first game 11-7, having led. Of course, 7-5 in that game, then had the run against her. And then in that second, it was 3 game points, isn't it, that Wang needed.
Oh.
Swats that away.
It's a beautiful receive there. Mima right off the bounce and the follow-up finishing attack so low. What to choose for the serves.
Let
it looks like a basketball in her hand. Just goes to show you how much body motion, how much torque there is when she twists, even on the serve, that sweat flies off between let serves.
Picked again.
One, two.
Not by too much there. Striking down on Edito. losing a succession of points here to Wang. And in the wider context, not just this third game, look at that. 11 of the last 16 now for the Chinese.
When you saw the replay of the last point, to rally with those shots, those flat, low shots that Mima makes with almost no swing.
Oh.
Finally, something that forces Wang Manyu to move back into the table with a long leaping lunge. Really takes the pace off this second shot. Slows it way down. No follow through, nice and shallow. That's the one. Devastating, almost a second bounce on the table. Coach Mott taking his notes.
That's long.
3-4.
And gone short into the forehand as well, shoveling it through before. Haven't seen that, have we, that fast long? Throwing it in as a disguise.
Yeah, keeping the opponent guessing, it's sort of like the coffee beans between the fragrances you're smelling. Just a little palate cleanse to keep the receiver guessing.
And went there again.
5-3.
This time a different outcome. To punch holes into the Wang Manyu game, but it's basically every player finds in the sport right now that's very difficult to do.
Yeah, her game is holy in some senses, but you have to check the spelling on that.
I mean, even there. The thing is, she's lost that point, but you look side to side there, Adam, in terms of Wang Manyu. What I always think with her is her just saying earlier, there's an earlier commentary we did, but with her, the recovery, that's best in class, isn't it, in the women's game right now?
It's incredible, and she's got no shortage of wingspan either.
I mean, look there, how she's won that point. Pushed to her limits, but she finds new ones.
Think about how many shots it would take. I mean, corner to corner, Mima working. First looking for the middle, and then the opportunity to go to the corners and test the feet. Physical fitness on the Chinese team, I mean, it sets the standard.
8-4.
Gloriously put away here.
I think that serve came up a little bit more than Mima Chan would have wanted. Good execution to sort of clean up on the opportunity there.
Yeah,
from
that's what it's leading to. 3 points away.
Fanning backhand.
5.
The way she wraps around that ball, it's already tricky enough for backhand that she's got short pips there. But when you make a shot like that, I mean, it's so tough from that depth to even attack. Wang Manyu, if she's forced into a passive shot, leaves it there for the Mima smash.
Six.
I don't know about you, but I was watching Mima's knees before she started that point. And a few players have very quirky sort of just little things that they do to get ready, their rituals. Her and Hugo Calderano have an unusual sort of step before they spring into the receive. Good recovery there off the top of the net.
3 in a row. Big point coming up here. And the serve to come for Ito.
Saving the timeout for later, should the match extend.
I think they've both used them, haven't they? Used them both in the second, Adam.
And by saved, I mean used. My bad. Whoa. If she had had one, it would have been the type of time where you might expect to see one. After being up 8-4 and having 3 points scored against you, but
No, definitely would have come in, yeah, but not available anymore. He used them in fairly quick succession in the second. That's a big point there for Wang to take, just to stay in front, two away.
Let 9-7.
Come on, so good.
9-8.
Again.
When you think about the value of each step, Mima Ito, one step is about 0.5 of Wang Manyu's steps, but still she finds herself in a good position, meaning she's got half the length in her step. Wang Manyu, for every Wang Manyu step is 2 of Mima Ito's, but she was right there in the forehand after that long travel to the backhand corner to finish the point.
9-0.
Well, fluctuating here. Ito with her service here out of the towel break. Got back to nines. Possibilities here of going into a fourth game. Has just not missed by very much, has it?
If you blinked and forgot the point itself before that replay, I mean, I didn't know if it was going to come down in that replay. That's how close it was.
Safer receive from Wang Manyu that time. And Ito able to get in.
Yeah, I think we should put the word safe in quotes there. Slightly more cautious, but against Mima Ito, maybe it's not safe. Game point now for Mima Chun.
Oh, how good was that?
I thought she almost hit her racket on the table. I'll be curious to see Tomahawk. And that's very low. Hey, that was tough.
10-0.
Low, deep push. And still, it stayed close enough to the back of the table that Mima Chun was caught in between spinning and going for the Mima punch.
Game point she's missed out on. And now again here, just as in the second game, we're at 10s with the serve rotating. 2 points, the winning margin required.
10-11.
Is it going to be another one of those? Again, we talk about China against Japan and the women's side of things, particularly these big moments. You know, we had the first quarterfinal of the day, 8s in the fifth, Chen Meng and Hina Hayata here. And we're not as that advanced as that, but here, that situation, does Wang Manyu do what's needed? First match point. No, not that
11-0.
Time.
We saw this from the coaching as well. We saw it from Lily Zhang when she was playing without a coach. Just reminding yourself, as Wang Manyu did here, to stay calm. It's easy when your toes are approaching the finish line, but you haven't crossed it yet. Still clocked in for work. I think the facial expression
11-12.
Of Mima Ito said it all here. Watch it. Tough times. Decent
Indeed.
Opportunity there, and she knew what she wanted to do, but match point once again for Wang Manyu.
Second opportunity. And this time she's done it. See what it means to her, wheeling away in delight there, the world champion. Wang Manyu sees off Mima Ito in straight games. It was tighter than that, but she finds a way into the final four here at this inaugural WTT Champions European Summer Series. The world champion still going strong here.